Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
And happy day 7 of Vlogmas.
So I was thinking and I was like, what is something I could do that might be helpful to other people? If you know me or you've seen my TikToks before, you know that I do a lot of acting type of videos and a lot of point of views or POVs. So I thought it would be a good idea to make a video showing you guys how I make my point of views and give you guys some tips that I know that I think could personally help you guys out. If you're new here, make sure you go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe so if I do more videos like this, you guys can, you know, already be here. So let's get into the video. I'll insert a few videos of point of views that I have done before to give you guys a little taste of a lot of the videos I do, just in case you aren't following me on TikTok. Now that we've done that, let's get into the behind the scenes action, tips, and all that good stuff. Lighting is key when you're making TikTok. In my opinion, any type of TikTok, lighting is key. I'm gonna show you guys what I use for my lighting. I personally use a ring light. I just got this new one that I love. I'll show you guys. So this is the ring light that I use. I'm actually using it right now for this video. It's like that, and then that's how big the little ring is. And then it comes with this little holder thing that you can put your phone in. It also has an adjustable stand so you can like lift it and lower it as you please. This is what the back looks like. You can turn up the lighting. You can make the color a little different. So yeah, I really like this. It's very helpful. Having a ring light is very helpful to me because I'm busy a lot of the time, so I don't always have time to make my TikToks right away. So a lot of the time I make them at night when I have a little downtime. The ring light for me is a savior because my room, it's pretty dark for some reason. My lamp is not that good. But if you don't have a ring light, you could always ask for one for Christmas or try to invest in getting one. I know that's easier said than done, and sometimes ring lights are low-key expensive. If you don't have a ring light, that's okay. We can work with what we have. I would say to use all the lighting that you do have. You know, lamps or anything like that. Even your LED lights can help sometimes. But if none of that is available, I would suggest making your TikToks earlier in the day when it's still bright outside. And I would suggest making them near a window to help you get more lighting. Now I'm going to show you guys a behind the scenes of me making one. Usually I will start my point of views off in front of my closet just because it's a bit of a more simple background. That way the people that are viewing it don't get super distracted by everything that's behind me. So I would suggest, you know, trying to find like a spot that's not super cluttered and, you know, a basic wall would work or anything like that. Then I get my ring light and I usually adjust the height to where I want it. So for me, I like it a bit taller so the angle will be like more eye level. And then my phone will go in this little thing right here. So usually I don't always necessarily have a plan for what kind of point of view I'm gonna do. There's three ways that I pick a sound that I'm going to use. I will scroll through the For You page and sometimes there'll be a sound that's just like right there that I'm like, I like this, I'm gonna use this. Or if I know it's a very popular sound and I see it on the For You page, I'll usually try to use it. Other than that, I do also save sounds. Like when I'm not doing nothing and I'm not ready and I'm like not prepared, I usually save sounds. If you guys don't know how to do that, I'll show you. But basically, when you're scrolling through your For You page, she's pretty. I just click on the little circle, and then, oh, this one's already added to my favorites, but at the top you can add to favorites, and then that way later I can come back and look at my saved sounds by clicking the little bookmark tag, and I can pick out of like a list of the sounds that I have. If I don't do that, I'll usually just click the plus sign at the bottom, and then I'll click sounds. And I'll usually look for one on the recommended, or I'll scroll through like the rest of the sounds. I'm trying to show you guys focus. Or I'll scroll through here and see if there's any sounds that I like. When picking a sound, I usually either pick one that I know is popular so it can hopefully gain more attraction, or sometimes I will step out and use a sound that's not super popular, because sometimes those actually do better than doing a video with a popular sound. When I do storylines, I like sounds that aren't too, you know, I don't want the viewers to be super distracted by the music, but sometimes the music does work, like the lyrics and stuff, if it goes with the vibe that you're going for. Okay, so this is a recent TikTok that I did. It was called A Cinderella Story. So I saw this one and it sounded like super, I don't know, it just gave me like, not Disney, but like, you know, princessy, you know, romantic type vibe. So I decided to do like a little Cinderella story. I like the sound to go with the theme of the point of view I'm doing, because I'm not gonna do a romance point of view with like a sound that's like raging or like, you know, creepy. You know, sometimes I'll pick the sound based off of the words. This is the most recent point of view that I did. I did it to where what I'm saying actually matches up with the lyrics. Okay, so yeah, you get the gist. So right now, I'm just gonna pick one from sounds that I've saved. Or sometimes I will also save people's videos if I liked what they did or I thought it was cool or I liked the sound. This one, she's so pretty, but her videos scared the hell out of me. Now I'm gonna use that little sound right here. Angles. When you're filming a point of view, I like to zoom in a bit to make it more close up to my face. I just think it gives it a bit more of a cinematic view. You want to give your videos that like special effect-ish. Because if it's just like straight up, like far away and your whole body's in it, it's not as effective in my opinion. Sometimes it does work. It just depends on what you're doing and what kind of point of view. So I'll listen to the sound a few times to try to get a vibe for what kind of point of view I'm gonna do. Okay, then I'll usually take a few steps back. So it's not as up close. I think I want to do something like crazy girlfriend effect. I have this drawer that I use. I call it the prop drawer. It's just full of things that are kind of random, but I feel like could work with a type of point of view. This is what I call the prop drawer. It just has, you know, stuff that could be useful for a little point of view video. Calculator, glasses. Flashlight, just stuff like that. And then I have handcuffs and all that type of stuff. I have a knife. Don't judge me. I don't know. I want to come off crazy. So I think I'm going to use these handcuffs and possibly use this. Possibly. Not sure. Okay, I have an idea. I think I'm gonna pretend like I done kidnapped my ex or something because he fell out of love with me. I'm literally just coming up with this on the spot. Okay, we're gonna pretend that my ex fell out of love with me and I kidnapped him because I'm upset, okay? Basically, he's knocked out, and in the beginning, I'm gonna pretend like he just woke up and I'm just there and like he has handcuffs on. And he's gonna call me crazy or something, and then I'm gonna get mad. Yeah, okay. I want this to be more. I also like closer angles because they can't always see what you're doing outside of it. I'm gonna start off in this area of my room because we need different scenery. Now I need to switch the sound to 60 seconds. I can shoot up to 28 seconds. It tells me at the little top in blue. Oh, we're gonna pretend I put something in his drink. Now I'm gonna use this cloth to cover my screen. I'm gonna slightly change the angle. It's not much help. But basically I zoomed the camera even more in to where it's just a close-up of this and my hand. I'm just gonna put a little bit of hand sanitizer in here. I'm gonna squeeze it. It's gonna look like some type of liquid's coming out. And then I'll wash this after. Oh shoot, I heck of missed. Such a waste of hand sanitizer. I'm gonna do it to right before she starts singing. Okay, that's good. And then this scene is basically gonna be me giving him the drink. Put it over here. Now I'm gonna put my phone on the ground because I want it to look like he's looking up at me. Let's see, I don't want the ring light in it. So I'll do it right here. Now I'm gonna put the handcuffs on. No, that looks so weird. Okay, I'm just gonna lean over him and show the handcuffs. The angle is back in front of my closet. Nice, it's already on red. So I'm gonna turn my light down. So it's darker, but I kinda want it up a little bit. Okay, I think I'm gonna do it like this. So I finished the TikTok, or at least I finished putting the words in and stuff, so I will show you guys. You should beware of a woman with a broken heart. Baby, that's I'm calling me baby, that's I'm calling me crazy. Baby, that's I'm calling me baby. Now, I don't do this with all of my TikToks, but I wanted to show you guys in this video that I do for some of my TikToks use other apps to like edit them a little more, just to give them a little more pizzazz. What I do is most of the time I'll either use Prequel or I'll use this app called Premiere Rush that you can download on the App Store. The only thing with Premiere Rush is that it does cost money. But as an alternative, there is Prequel. I don't know how to say it. There is that app as well, which I think is pretty good. It has a lot of like effects and filters that you can use. I mainly just use the Rush one more for like smoother or cooler transitions. With the TikTok, I will usually post it, but I post it to my private account, that way I can only see it and nobody else can. Now I'm going to go to my private section where the little lock sign is. I have 7% too. Oh my god. I go to the video, and then where it has the three little dots, I click on that, and then I click live photo. So then it's gonna save to my camera roll as like a live picture thing. This is basically just a way to get the video without having the huge TikTok watermark sign on it. And once that's saved, I go to my photo albums. I click the little, this button over here, and then I click save as video. And there it saves the video, but with a smaller TikTok watermark on it. Ready to export. I click export. And then I'm done, ready to share. Then I go to TikTok. And then I just click on the sound again. And then upload. And then I click the new video at the bottom. And then next. And then it will like make the sound go twice. So then you have to go to sounds, volume, and then I just put original sound to 100 and then added sound to 0. Now it's ready to go up. I just need to add a caption, but for now I'm going to just save it to my drafts until I have time to put the caption and post it. That is pretty much it for this video. If you guys want a more in-depth video or another video with just more tips, let me know. Also, make sure you go check out my other videos and stay tuned for my upcoming ones for the rest of Vlogmas. Thanks for watching. Peace out, Girl Scouts.
Yo, that was so cringe.